And now I can say I am joined with my second guest of the evening, indie pro wrestler from Philadelphia. You may know her as Roxy Cotton, but nowadays she goes by Gabby Gilbert, and she is now joining me on the show. Good evening, Gabby.
Hi.
How you doing?
I'm okay. I'm a little sick, so I'm sorry if my mom or raspy like.
Oh, it's okay. It's all right. Hope you're feeling better, though.
Me too.
This hurts. Yeah, being out in the weather can certainly suck at times. I completely understand.
Right? How are you?
I'm feeling great. And again, thank you for being on.
No problem. Wait, you said I was your second guest. Who was your first?
First guest is Mary Elizabeth Monroe.
Nice. How was that interview?
I had a good time. Met her a couple of times on wrestling shows. She's a sweetheart, a very talented wrestler out there in the Midwest. She wrestles in Ohio and in Kentucky. I've seen her wrestle a couple of times. She's a very good.
Awesome.
But let's get to more on you, Miss Gilbert, and
talk about me.
Yeah, talk about you. Talk a little bit about yourself and. How did you get started in professional wrestling?
How did I get started? Well, I used to watch it my whole life growing up. Me and my sister, we used to watch it with my dad and all. And then one day, I just saw a thing that, the Unreal Story of Pro Wrestling, that documentary. And then I was like, oh, wow, there's schools for this. And then I went online and I kept looking up some schools until I found one. And then there you go.
And, of course, you were first known as Roxy Cotton, and you now call yourself...
Actually, I was first known as something else, but, I mean, okay. I was more known as Roxy Cotton. Okay, go ahead.
Okay, obviously you have the name changed and everything, and for those who may or may not know, what made you decide to go with the name change?
One, because I really want people to chant my name instead of some stage name, and I want to be taken a little more serious, and I still want to have fun and be a great wrestler, but, you know, I'm tired of being a jobber. I want some more belts, and only one way to show it.
Do you remember?
Serious ass-kicking time. That's what's happening.
That's what I'm talking about. That's what I'm talking about.
Right? Just like when you're in bed. Do you want people to scream, like, your name or some name that, like, a nickname?
Well put. I
want them to scream my name. Scream my name, bitches.
Gabby,
am I allowed, bitches?
Yes, that's okay. Like, when it's okay. We're not a PG show, so we're good. You can curse up a storm if you want to. I probably should have...
All right.
So, do you remember the first match you ever had? And if so, who was your opponent and where was it located?
My first match was my first show or my first match? My first match was in Philadelphia. It was a mixed tag match with me and New Wave. At the time, his name was New Wave, and I think he goes by Dave Logan or Jim Logan right now. Versus Miss Dixie and Captain Rick Adams. It was in Philadelphia, and it was awesome. I had tons of fun.
And what was that like to have your first match in your hometown? Not a whole lot of wrestlers can say that.
Right? It was crazy. It was nice because my sister got to come out to it, and she got to support me. She's not a big wrestling person, so it's awesome. She still comes out and supports me. And, I don't know, it was pretty cool. It was hard to get work in Philly in general and have it be my hometown even more often.
How would you describe your wrestling style?
My wrestling style? I have no idea what my wrestling style is. I think it's like I'm going to either try something that I think is cool or try something that I think will just work. I don't know, like, something that will take you off your guard so that I can win. That's where I'm going with that. I have no idea. I like to change it up. like change it up.
You're a variety type of lady. I like that.
Right? Because you don't know what style they are, and you gotta be, great at all the styles so you can be any kind of person, not just the one style. You know what I mean?
Absolutely.
And you don't want it the same position all the time. You gotta change it up a little. Sometimes you wanna be on top, sometimes you wanna be on the bottom, sometimes you need to be in a handstand, whatever.
Well put. Let me ask you this. You've been on both sides. You've been a baby face, you've been a heel. What role do you like being best? You like being the baby face, get cheer on? Do you like being the heel, being booed and hated?
Honestly, if you really watch me be heel or face, I'm kind of the same person either way. So it's really, I guess, the person I'm wrestling or the crowd. I mean, either I'm really annoying and you hate me, or I'm really funny and you love me. So some people's moods change, and there you go. I don't know. I like to be me either way.
Well, I like you no matter what.
Exactly.
Do you have any upcoming shows that you want to promote?
I have a lot of stuff going on. Okay, so right now I'm totally wrestling a bunch of stuff, and all of my site my events are on my website, which is www.gabbygilbert.com. And you need the W's, and I don't know why that is like that, but if you don't put the W's in, it won't work. So you gotta put the W's in. And I'm also doing co-ed touch football, and those dates are also on my website. And the funny thing is, I don't really know how to play football, so I'm out there just running around screaming, and which is another reason why my throat and my voice is all raspy. But like the guys, there's girls and guys on it, right? And both girls and guys were complaining that I was hitting too hard. Like, oh man, this chick's like hitting too hard. It's definitely an illegal block. They're all like crying about it. The guy was all like fat and everything, but I was knocked his ass over. I was like, listen, you ran into me. I'll tell you. And I got some other things going on. So some of you guys know that I do stand-up comedy, and I haven't been doing as much because I'm trying to do more of the wrestling. It's very hard to balance everything at once. But there's one comedy troupe, Comedy 215, which is the area code, the telephone area code for Philadelphia. They had a big modeling contest for the boys and the girls of Comedy 215, and I just happened to win that the other day, and now they're having a show tomorrow night. It's $100 to get in, but I know it sounds pricey because it's like ridiculous because you got $100, but it's on like a yacht in Philadelphia on the Columbus Boulevard, and you get 4 hours of unlimited like free top shelf liquor and beer and food, like really good food. Plus like the proceeds go to some kickball thing in Philadelphia. Plus there's like the other 215 girls are gonna be there, and it's gonna be awesome. You guys should come out and watch some hysterical comedy. The main guy is Chris Smith, who's like the funniest guy ever. Like, no matter what, like just like he can work like talk about different styles, like for comedy. He's like he can work any style also, and he will make everybody laugh because he's freaking hysterical. This guy needs his own like thing, stuff.
All
You should
right.
come out.
I live in
So that's where I'll be tomorrow night. You should go.
If you are in the Philadelphia area, check out Gabby Gilbert. Check her out. Get laugh your
Yeah,
ass off.
if you order the tickets ahead of time, they'll be cheaper. And if you but you still can get them at the door. And if you want them cheaper, email yellowitzeric@yahoo.com, and he'll hook you up. Or just find me on Facebook, and I'll send you information.
And again, check out the website, GabbyGilbert.com.
Yeah, I'll just put it on Gabby Gilbert. You gotta put the www.gabbygilbert.com. Because if you don't put the W's, you're not gonna find me. Well, you probably find me because I'm awesome. How can you not find me?
All
You want
right.
me? You'll find me. Oh, you'll want me. You'll find me.
Most
You gonna
definitely.
find me? Do you want me?
Of course, I want
You don't sound
to.
that excited.
Yes,
Why aren't you
yes.
excited that you want me? I don't feel
Yes,
it. I don't feel it.
yes. I do, Miss
Oh,
Gilbert.
so I gotta like put you in a weird position? Is that the problem? Like, I don't understand how.
No,
Why?
you don't have
What?
to. You
How do
don't.
I get you more excited about me?
I'm excited that you're here. I'm excited.
That doesn't sound. That sounds like you're faking it. That sounds like a fake. I'm a girl. I know how to fake it. So
Well,
just
maybe
one.
that.
What do I gotta do? What I gotta do? Just want to know from the fans. What do I have to do for you fans to either come out more often or watch more wrestling or what? Do you want to see like different gear? Do you want to see different moves? Do you want to see? I don't. What do you got? What do the fans want to see out of Gabby Gilbert? That's what I want to know. Make that happen. Figure it out. And get back to me. Maybe I'll show it to you.
Hey, I like to see
You
you
let me
know
show it to you?
I like to see you no matter what it is that you're doing. Wrestling, comedy, you do what fits you, and I'll check it.
Well, I've been trying for a while to get this cooking show started. And it's taking a little while because a tree fell on my house. My kitchen's kind of not really up to date right now. But I'm trying to do pots, pans, and pro wrestling and have me and another wrestler cook, whether it's talk about like their stuff going on in their life or make some meals that they go if they're on a diet or anything or just on the road favorites and talk a little about them and then maybe show some wrestling. So keep your eyes open for that, guys, because it's coming soon. Pots, pans, and pro wrestling, Gabby Gilbert.
Now, what do you consider as the highlight of your wrestling career thus far?
Wow. I don't know. There's so I got a few. The fact that me and Annie Social, we are the Beatdown Betties. We were the very first female tag champs in WSU, the first tag champs they ever had. And so that's pretty cool to have a belt in an all-girls company. It's hard to do. And let's see. And then me and Sumi Sakai, together we're Harajuku Musumi, and we held the World One Tag Titles. We're the very first girls to ever win them, and that was pretty honor being that who all held those belts, like for people from Japan and like all over the world, and the fact that we got to hold them, that was pretty cool. The fact that I even went to Japan in general is awesome. I was the very first women's champion of the state of Maryland, so that was a big honor, and like that was. Of all these years, I couldn't believe that like there was no female, like a women's champion in that state, and they finally got a champion, and I was the first one, so that was pretty awesome. And when I went down to Mexico, I held a belt there. I held the LLF junior belt, so that was pretty cool to go like hold a belt in a different country. It's freaking hysterical. Like it's crazy. It's ridiculous. And I don't know how I got it, but I did, and I won, and I held it for a while. And I'm going back down to Mexico in November for LLF. So keep a lookout for that. And if you guys want to see the stuff that I've done on down in Mexico when I won the belt and everything, it is on my YouTube page. And my YouTube page still says Roxy Cotton because I don't know how to change the name. But or just go to my page and find the links. And there you go. And my name was Extreme Girl for a while under there because I was under mask. So you could find all that on YouTube because people are like really good with computers. I don't know about you.
You pretty much got championships everywhere, from America to Japan to Mexico.
I'm trying. I'm
Girl,
trying.
next thing you know, you're gonna be getting championships all over the world, and you're gonna get all up as a.
Hopefully on some like bigger companies, maybe. Wink, wink.
And I love Annie Social, a very talented
Right?
wrestler out
I
there.
love her too, and I'm glad she loves me because she's a scary chick. I don't know why she likes me, but she does, and I'm not gonna complain.
Hey, the personalities mesh. I mean, you're very outgoing and bubbly, and Annie's a no-nonsense gal that likes to kick ass, and you both kick ass together, and the chemistry, it just goes in sync.
I know. It's like I think we're very similar at the same time, complete opposites, and I think that's what makes us fit so well. And if she do anything for me, and I do anything for her, and I'm also in another tag. I'm like tag teaming it all up all over the place. I don't know how this is. I'm in a tag team with Annie Social called Beatdown Betties. I'm in a tag team with Marty Bell, and we're called the Punky Bruisers. I'm in a tag team with Sumi Sakai, and we're the Heretic from Sumi. And I've held belts with all three of them. And I'm also in a tag team with Luscious Latasha. And together we are Rainbow Bright. And we have yet to hold a tag belt, so people need to book us and make that happen so I can win some more belts under my name.
The more
I'm like the female. I feel like I'm the female Billy Gunn right now with all these tag teams.
that's a nice comparison right there. That's a nice the female Billy Gunn. It's got a nice swing to it.
You know who I would love to be compared to? Cole Cabana. If I could be compared to, like, if I was known as the female Cole Cabana, I think that'd be like such a great honor. Like, I hope like that's the way I want to go with my life, is being the female Cole Cabana. He's awesome. He's got a cool style. He's got a funny style, but he can like wrestle and kick your ass at the same time. So I think like if anything, my style was something of his ish. I have no idea what my style is. I don't know what I'm saying. Hi.
I believe you have Coco Bana in you. I believe it.
Yeah. I have a little cool about it, Amy.
Yes, you do. Yes, you
Like a
do.
little bit more.
Yeah,
Wink,
you.
wink.
So, is there any other wrestlers out there that you haven't had the chance to work with but would like to work with someday?
Natsuki Zateo, I would love to work her, and Gao Kim. There's so many people that I want to wrestle. I wrestled Daisy Hayes once, and I wasn't as good as I think that I am now. Not saying that I'm not good anyway, but like I'm better than I was when I first wrestled her. I'd love to get a rematch. I don't know if it's gonna happen because she's always hurt. That'd be awesome to have a rematch with her. I would like to wrestle anybody. Anyway, Cole Cabana. I want to wrestle Cole Cabana. I want to tag team with Cole Cabana. That'd be cool. That'd be cool. Like my dream match would things that would never happen would be like Undertaker or something. But that's probably never gonna happen.
Yeah, you know what they say in the wrestling business, never say never.
Right? It will totally happen. It'll be the greatest match of all time, and then I wake up and I was like, "Oh man!"
Now, would you like to face the Undertaker for 20 years ago or the current Undertaker?
Oh man, that's hard to say. I think I would like to wrestle the Undertaker. Like, remember back in the day when you wrestled Undertaker versus fake Undertaker? I think that era of Undertaker would be the awesomest one to wrestle.
Yeah, back in the day when he was wearing the purple gloves or the silver gloves. Yeah.
Right?
Yeah. I'm not sure. I'm not so sure about the current Undertaker with that mohawk. I'm not feeling it whatsoever. Go back to the long hair Undertaker. I'm just saying. I'm just saying.
You know, he can't help the short hair. He's kind of losing it, so.
Or maybe Michelle McCool told him to cut the hair. I don't know.
Maybe she told him to cut the hair because he's losing it. They're like, maybe if you do this, it won't look as bad.
Hey, when a woman talks, a man listen. I guess.
She's the one that's got to stare at his face when they're doing it, unless they're doing it in a different position. I'm just saying. You've got to deal with it.
There you go.
She's got to look at it a third of the time.
I am happily excited to be joined
You're
by
excited?
Captain.
How excited are you? Are you like semi-excited? Are you like extremely excited?
Oh, I'm extremely excited. I am
This lady.
extremely excited to be joined with Gabby
Really?
Gilbert.
Are
Yes,
you
I
like
am.
so extremely excited that you're gonna poke me on Facebook after this?
Well, I've never poked someone before, but if you want me
You
to.
never poked somebody before? Are you a poke virgin here? You have to poke me then. Can I be your first? I'll de-virginize you.
Okay.
And if you really like it, maybe I'll poke you back if you're into that kind of thing. We'll test it out a little, see what you like. You're a virgin, you don't know anything about it, so you're like, how do you know if you like it unless you try it?
Whatever floats your boat, Miss Gabbert.
I'm closing my boat.
Whatever works right with you. And before I let you go, Gabby, I'll ask our guests to do this. It's like a station ID. It's like a voice drop. All you have to do is say your name. And right after you say your name, you say you are listening to Triple Threat Wrestling Radio.
Can I do it right now?
Yeah, go right ahead.
Right now? Like the second that I just passed what I said right now?
Go right ahead.
All right. So, I'm Gabby Gilbert, and you're totally listening to Triple Threat Wrestling Radio. It's so cool. Keep listening for all the other cool stars and stuff. Okay.
I think I'm in love.
Better?
That was better.
Better?
That was great.
That better?
I love it.
Now, do you want me to scream your name out, or do I have to keep saying my own name? I don't think I've ever said my own name. I might have said the wrong name. This is why I call out people's names. You know, you're gonna call out the wrong name. You're all put on the spot, calling out names. You're like, gotta remember who you're screaming. I mean, not saying. You know.
What you said.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah.
Well, Gabby, it was great talking to you, and thank you
Great
so
talking to
much.
you too.
Great having you on. Best of success goes out to you in wrestling, in comedy, and your and many more endeavors you have. Thank you for your time, and I had a
Thank
blast.
you guys.
And you have a good evening.
You too.
Bye
Bye.
bye. That was Gabby Gilbert, the ever so entertaining Gabby Gilbert.